Hi guys, I'm Nancy, and I'm going to show you super easy ways to find the horizontal asymptote for any rational expression that you're given. There are basically three cases, and if you know those three, then you're set. So to do this, you're going to need to know what the degree of a polynomial is. So for instance, if your polynomial is x squared plus 3x plus 4, the degree is the highest power of x that appears in your polynomial. So in this case, x squared is the highest power of x, and the degree is 2. The degree is 2, so it's that power. Okay, so this is a trick to know the horizontal asymptote. It's a rule that you can use. So the first case, what if your degree on top is less than your degree on the bottom? So in this case, degree on top is 1 for the x and 2 for the x squared. So if your degree on top is less than the degree on the bottom, then your horizontal asymptote, HA, will always be y equals 0, which is the x-axis. So that would be the answer. Whenever the degree on top is less than the degree in the denominator, your horizontal asymptote is y equals 0. Second case, if your degree on top is the same as your degree on the bottom, and in this example that's x squared on top, x squared on bottom, so the degree is 2 on top and 2 on the bottom, then your horizontal asymptote you will get by dividing the leading term on top by the leading term on bottom. So x squared divided by 3x squared, and simplify, and this leaves you with 1 over 3, since that was just a 1x squared. So your horizontal asymptote is y equals 1/3. So if the degrees are equal on top and bottom, you're going to end up with a horizontal asymptote that is y equals a number. Okay, third case, if your degree on top is larger than your degree on the bottom, you don't have a horizontal asymptote. So your answer is actually just none. For horizontal asymptotes specifically, you would write none. Now, in reality, you do have an asymptote in this case, but it's something called an oblique asymptote or a slant asymptote, and you would actually get it by using long division with polynomials, which I have a video for on how to do. You would divide this polynomial by that polynomial, and you would end up with another x expression using long division. And that would be your slant asymptote or your oblique asymptote. But you don't need to worry about that because you've been asked about horizontal asymptote and the answer is that it doesn't have one. So the answer is none. So these are the three cases. It's going to be one of these three cases, absolutely. Either lower degree on top than on bottom and the asymptote is y equals 0. Equal degrees and the asymptote is some number. Higher degree on top than on bottom, like top-heavy rational expression, and you have no horizontal asymptote, so none. So those three cases are all you need to remember. That's it. So I think what trips people up is that they think they need to use some formal definition of the limit to find the horizontal asymptote. You don't. For a rational expression, meaning numerator over denominator, or rational function, you really just need to remember these three rules. Is the top power, highest power, larger than the bottom highest power? Is it equal? Is it less than? In those three cases. So don't mess with limits. Just remember the rule. So I know that was a lot of fun. It's okay. You don't have to like math. But you can like my video. So if you do, click like below.